And welcome to 128 Byte. Today we will talk about high-tech composite materials which are used instead of steel across industries. Now, why is this topic so important to us? Until a few years ago, mostly used materials in bike production was steel and more recently alloy. But with major improvements made in automotive industry, along came new, more advanced materials like carbon and composite plastics. These materials made huge leaps in performances in both cars and bicycles, making them stiffer, lighter, and ultimately faster. Now, if properly handled, these composite materials are very much sustainable and can be recycled easily. For example, we have a new frame factory in Germany now, which is making bike frames automatically out of recycled carbon and composites. One more benefit with these materials is that they are fast to be produced, don't use much energy in the production process, and most of the time price is competitive. As you can imagine, price is a really important point with entry-level and mid-range bicycles, so factories often opt for using combinations of the old and new technology to get the best results. For example, mudguards use plastic combined with aluminum sheets to make the perfect combination of strength, lightweight, and long lifetime. There are bottom brackets with composite cups and sleeves instead of steel ones, which are combined with steel bearings and spindles, making them lighter and easier to service. Then there are saddles, carriers, pedals, brake levers, and lists go on and on. Sometimes in biking industry there is a resistance towards new materials by older generation who has the perception that plastics and materials which feel of plastic like in your hands will break and that it will not last. They always prefer heavy duty steel when comparing it with lightweight composite materials. Then they go on to do maintenance and service work to the bicycle, cursing the rust when the components are stuck and suffering when having to change the same material they just praised a minute ago. So in conclusion, we all need to be open-minded to new technologies and investigate how it can improve our bicycles and make our lives easier in the long run. Personally, I have been surprised and proven wrong many times in the past when I was discussing about these new technologies. So be patient and open-minded and don't make the same mistakes I did. Thank you for your attention. Make sure to visit my website 128.bike and comment if you have any questions or want to contribute to this topic. See you again soon. Bye.